Hey, happy Thursday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Now, we still have a big storm coming next week after we deal with all this, and everything looks good in the atmosphere for a powerful storm, bringing chances for damage and winds, also chances for tornadoes, maybe even some large hail. Also, I have an update on what's going on with the temperatures. I will update you real quick on that. I do see a change that is coming around the corner, about the middle of the month. Now, you see, we still have that huge snowstorm happening for Colorado and New Mexico. Showing, matter of fact, it's still maybe almost 4 feet, if not that, on some peaks. Now, you can see Rafael right now, and it is still maybe get a Cat 2 status, a hurricane, maybe even all the way up to a Cat 3. It all depends. The loop current don't really have a lot of heat right now, but it has enough where it could help it a little bit. Now, once it gets to the western side of the Gulf of Mexico, this is where it's projected to go further towards the south. It does have a high upper level high that's going to be bending this down to the south, and it's not showing it's going to capture that trough too much. Now, what I'm showing is that we're going to see a wobble. We're going to see a wobble of south, north, south, north, and then just dissipate. And it's going to do that back and forth the whole time. So it's going to be a southern, northern. That's why you see this big outlook right here. Now, latest projections do take it further towards the southern side, like I was talking about yesterday. And what's happening with this one? This one has gone down to 20%. It's going to gradually move into the western Caribbean, where I'm showing it's also going to get demolished by this front. And you can see the latest tracks on what's going on with Rafael. You can see some of them saying northern, and then whoop, come right back south, just get really whipped around from this jet stream. You're going to see it wobble back and forth. Latest update shows, like I said yesterday, no further impacts for northern Gulf of Mexico. Matter of fact, they're showing southern and southwestern Gulf of Mexico is who should monitor progress of the system. Now, you can also see in 48 hours, National Hurricane Center has it over here. And as we go a little bit further to 72 hours, you see it does wobble a little bit to the north. After this is where they're projecting it to go further towards the south. You're going to see that northern and southern wobble a little bit. Now, you can see this when you look at the latest dynamics of the atmosphere, that as it continues to go further to the west from the high pressure, you can see the trough doesn't grab it, and the trough goes up with that storm system and just leaves it. It does not grab it in time, and that goes further towards the west and south. Also showing once it gets around 48 hours and further to the west, all that shear that it is hitting it is going to throw some dry air in there as well, and that's going to start getting wrapped around that system and weakening it down, and the shear is going to dwindle it down as well. And if it tries to go northern, which the GFS is still hitting it, it could wobble on that northern wobble just a little bit more. So much shear hitting it is still weakened down as well. You can see the latest on the ensembles with the Euro, that as that goes further to the west, if it does wobble further to the north, look how much weaker those are if it does happen to break off. Majority of them is showing as you go past 4 days, it will be over here still in the southern Gulf of Mexico. That next wave will be something very weak, and it will not handle anything. It will come around southern Florida, maybe bring a little bit of precipitation. While Rafael goes into Mexico is the census. Then what builds next in the Caribbean, showing it will hang around the Yucatan, maybe around the central Caribbean. So we still got to watch what builds up later. I'm still showing everything is going to be a little further towards the east, but we still got to watch out for this portion as we still go through the rest of November. You can see with the GFS ensembles, it is trending a little more of that northern, but at the same time, look how quickly that weakens down and just brings potentially more rainfall, maybe some 30 miles per hour wind gusts. Nothing super major still, if that was even to show true. And so it could also go southern and be just as weak. And that what builds up next, we do need to watch out for in the Caribbean, because something is trying to form up. But remember, the trend has always been a little bit further towards the east on our lift, on our potential velocity anomaly, but it could come right back sometime into the 20s. Still showing around the 20s is going to be another intense moment, not only for the tropics, but another strong storm that's coming for the lower 48, and it could be a major snowstorm going across the northern tier of the U.S. But you can see here with the H-Wharf, how it gets that wobble north, then south, then it goes back north, then back south, just gets that wobble, and the trough never grabs a hold of that. It just stays there and windles down, and I do believe that is what we're going to see. And you see the latest potential velocity anomaly. We still have a lot of favorable environment all through November for more storms to form, everyone. And still showing with the latest Euro that it's a green, that we do have a lot of favorable environment all the way into the high teens. Then it's going to be a little wishy-washy. We do need to watch out for the 20th. I'm still showing something could happen, not only in the Caribbean, for the lower 48. And you can see as we go through the end of November and through December, look at everything. The Pacific, the Atlantic, everything starts getting active again. Because you can also see not only the favorable environment that is leaving, that we actually have a hurricane in that neutral phase right there, in that white. So as this moves over and we get sinking air propagating through, remember we got that little break. Be careful of these breaks. Remember, barrel formed in that. And then you see down here as we go towards December, it all comes back again. Now that's further down the road, so I will keep you updated. Make sure that you subscribe. Make sure you click that bell so you do get updates. Now when you look with the members, all the members, you go by the Euro, you go by GFS, regardless of whether it goes north or south. Look at this. This is showing by the Euro that more likely could take that little quick dip to the north. You see that? Just like the GFS is saying, bring you some rainfall. That's all it would do. You can see this in a few of them. Majority on the Euro shows that it will take that southern dip. See, there's another one right there. But the majority shows that it will take that southern dip or just dissipate and just go away in general. Now, the GFS is still going for that northern dip, but still, regardless whether it's southern or northern, look at this, is going to be something very weak. You won't even get any impacts. You might get some winds along the Gulf Coast, 30 miles per hour wind gusts. You might even enjoy that breeze. But as far as everything else, don't look like it's going to be super severe. It's going to be very weak, if anything. But you see how GFS is agreeing on that northern track or dissipating. Euro is showing that southern track or dissipating. So regardless, is dissipating. But just to be accurate, checking for the chances just for 20 knot winds, some 25 miles per hour wind gusts, possibilities, you can see with the GFS that you do have chances for it maybe come northern, bring some 25 miles per hour wind gusts along the Gulf Coast of Louisiana as you go through tomorrow, maybe hanging around a little bit for the weekend and weakening down as it hangs around. That's it. You can see the same thing with the Euro, that there is a chance to bring 25 miles per hour wind gusts right along the coast of Louisiana as you go through Friday, but then it weakens down over the weekend and then just moves away. But difference in the paths of precipitation. So you see in the next 6 days with the Euro bringing that precipitation towards Mexico, bringing some towards eastern Texas, Louisiana, then it goes towards Georgia and South Carolina. When you go by GFS, it's taking a little more of that northern wobble where you get all the precipitation along the Louisiana coast. You still have it for Georgia and South Carolina, but it dissipates for eastern Texas. Matter of fact, when you go to Weather Prediction Center, the meteorologist over there is seeing a little bit of that northern turn where it dissipates and goes away. So for today, you still have a slight risk for flash flooding. You have the marginal, but a slight risk is where you're going to see most of the ponding up on the roads and where you can get to isolated flood threats, especially down those dead-end roads that don't go nowhere, the cul-de-sacs. You got to watch out for that. Also over here for Texas and Oklahoma, while they're getting that major snow, you're going to get the heavier rainfall and get that chance for some flash flooding. As you go through tomorrow, this is going to grow for tomorrow and Saturday. You're in a slight risk all the way from Texas through Oklahoma and Kansas for flash flooding. As you go through Saturday, you can see it moves over with that storm system. Not showing a lot of severe weather, but you have it for Louisiana, northern Mississippi, Arkansas, northern Alabama, southeastern Missouri, western Tennessee, western Kentucky, and southern Illinois. Now, once you go from Saturday to Sunday, this is where it starts weakening down, but you still got a marginal for flash flooding. But then we're still getting that strong storm coming in for next Tuesday and Wednesday. Bringing storms right here in front of it. This is what you got to watch out for. What brews up in front of that? You see how these storms bring up. And you see the tight isobars. That's bringing strong winds as well. And as you go through Wednesday around noontime, look at this. Strong storms building up from the central to the northern U.S. and all the way to Wednesday night. All the way through Tennessee, Kentucky Valley, Ohio Valley, the Great Lakes, and maybe traversing all the way towards the intercoastal northeast. Chances for severe weather. So we do need to watch out for this next system coming through. You can see on your jet stream that it is going to start bringing some strong winds. This is going to help bring some thunderstorms and bring chances for your tornadoes and damaging winds as well as that moves all the way across. Your dew points are going to pull way up with some strong dew points. You're going to get a strong dry line right here for Texas, Oklahoma, and Kansas. Look like it's going to be a little bit eastern as that builds up, and then it goes across for Wednesday evening right across the south as well. So be careful. This is bringing a lot of dew points, a lot of cape, a lot of lift for these thunderstorms to feed on. You can see this as it builds up. It brings a lot of lift for these thunderstorms to feed on and create some severe weather. A lot of strong winds aloft. So as you go overnight Tuesday into Wednesday morning, this is where you're going to get some strong winds, bringing in strong storms, bringing some severe weather as you go into Wednesday morning. And then it's going to build as you go through Wednesday afternoon. Look at those winds. It's going to bring you damaging winds and some strong thunderstorms, especially as you go through Wednesday afternoon. Carries all the way across. You even get some strong winds on a wraparound. This could be pulling some colder air from the north as well. And you could be getting some snow from that. So you got to be watch out for that as well. Get some snow. Look, it goes all the way into Canada as you go overnight Wednesday into Thursday. Now, so far showing it could be anywhere from 40 to 50 miles per hour wind gusts as that system passes through. GFS is taking it a little bit stronger, where you're definitely going to see the 50s as that builds and brings a lot of strong winds. Definitely bringing those 40s and the 50s as it comes across. And look at the Great Lakes, Ohio Valley. This is bringing a lot of strong winds as that comes across, and it's going to bring severe weather with it. Showing so far with the Euro that you're still going to have Hurricane Rafael. Why are you getting these storms build up in the south central? You definitely got the severe weather for today. Also for tomorrow, where you're still getting that major snowfall, that feet of snow coming. Then showing that it will weaken down, take that southern dip according to the Euro as that goes across. But then next Wednesday, here comes that next storm system, bringing you chances for a squall line. Some storm cells that could be discrete in front of this that you need to watch out for could bring you chances for tornadoes also as you go through Wednesday afternoon. Look how it builds up. The squall line stays there, bringing you damage and winds. Storm strengthens, so you get cyclogenesis as well, a strengthening low pressure, bringing these damaging winds with this as you go through Wednesday night. Now, late night Wednesday, overnight into Thursday also. But it's also bringing strong winds on a wraparound. It could bring a mixed layer. It could bring some freezing rain. It could also bring some snow. It is bringing the winds. It is bringing that cooler air from the north. So for today, you still have the chance for the tornadoes at 2%. It did grow a little bit more. So far, here's your cities in Texas at threat for tornadoes today. You also have the chance for winds and the chances for hail for today. And this did grow until tomorrow. So far, it's a smaller 2% that could grow as well. So far, here's your cities in Texas at threat for tornadoes for tomorrow, for Friday. You also have the wind threat and hail threat. The tornado seems like the biggest threat. Also, when you check with Colorado State University for tomorrow, showing instead of that 2%, it could grow for northern Texas, northern Louisiana, into Arkansas, Oklahoma, and a little bit of Kansas. Plus, when you look at your latest AO, your Arctic Oscillation, you can see from yesterday how Euro showed that little dip. Nothing really was coming out of this coldness. When you look at the update today, it's kind of a green with the GFS. You're going to get a little bit of cold air that's going to dip through as you go around the 12th. This could bring a quick dash of some 50s towards the south. Then it's going to warm right back up again. But then come right back down again as you go anywhere from the 15th through the 20th. This is where cooler air will go a little bit further towards the southern U.S. and bring it also trending with GFS. GFS has seen it last a little bit longer. Euro is just now getting into it. It's a possibility it could go deeper. Right now it's saying it's going to go back on a warm-up. So I will keep you updated. So far it looks like the end of November, we could have a good spill of cold weather. Because when I go by all the models, you can see according to the trend that their green is going to be that little dip first, going to come in a little bit. But as you go towards the end of November, we potentially have some cooler air that's going to come all the way down towards Texas, towards northern Florida, all the way towards Arizona. Some really nice cold air. Thank you for your time, everybody. Hope this helps you understand what is happening not only now, but what is happening around the corner. If this has helped you, please consider hitting that share button down below. Let other people see this information as well. I appreciate you so much. Now, before I go real quick, 1 Thessalonians 3:6-16. Now, we command you, brethren, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that ye withdraw yourselves from every brother that walketh disorderly, and not after the tradition which he received of us. For yourselves know how ye ought to follow us, for we behave not ourselves disorderly among you. Neither did we eat any man's bread for naught, but wrought with labor and travail night and day, that we might not be chargeable to any of you. Not because we have not power, but to make ourselves an ensample unto you to follow us. For even when we were with you, this we command you, that if any would not work, neither should he eat. For we hear that there are some which walk among you disorderly, working not at all, but are busybodies. Now them that are such we command and exhort by our Lord Jesus Christ, that with quietness they work and eat their own bread. But ye, brethren, be not weary in well-doing. If any man obey not our word by this epistle, note that man and have no company with him, that he may be ashamed. Yet count him not as an enemy, but admonish him as a brother. Now the Lord of peace himself give you peace always by all means. The Lord be with you all. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll keep you updated on this next storm. It's looking like stronger and stronger. It could get a little further to the north. We will see what comes in the days after the weekend. And I'll keep you updated on what's coming at the end of November. Okay, it looks like we might be starting to finally going into the beginning of our winter. But remember, everyone, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody.